Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to convert a Word document into images using the Syncfusion Word Library. The Syncfusion Word Library, called DocIO, can programmatically convert a Word document into images in Windows, Linux, Docker, and cloud computing environments. This conversion function supports text, images, tables, hyperlinks, etc. Commonly used Word file formats such as doc, docs, and RTF can be converted into image formats like PNG, JPEG, and BMP. Please refer to the documentation link in the description below to learn more about Word-to-image conversion. In this video, I am going to explain the steps to convert entire pages in a Word document into images. I will also show you how to convert a specific range of pages or just the first page into images. First, I open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new aspdotnetcore web MVC application. Then, I name my project and continue with default target framework to complete project creation. Project is created successfully. To convert a Word document to an image in this application, I need the Syncfusion DocIO renderer library. I can reference it in the project by installing the Syncfusion DocIO renderer NuGet package. I open the NuGet package manager. In the Browse tab, I search for Syncfusion DocIO renderer NuGet package and install it in my application. I click OK to complete the installation. The package installation is now complete. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion trial license key in my application. To do that, I open the program.cs file and register a valid license key using the register license method. You can see where to generate this license key by following the link in the video description. Look at this Word document with text, images, and tables. I am going to convert this document to an image. I am going to explain three ways to do this: convert all pages, convert specific pages, and convert one page. So, in the index.cshtml file, I remove the existing code and add three buttons with click events. I specify the action method for each button. The next step is to define the action methods in the home controller. I go to the home controller and add a new action method named convert all pages. Similarly, I declare the other two methods named range of pages and thumbnail image. Then, I include the Syncfusion DocIO and DocIO renderer namespaces. Let me first show you how to convert the entire document. Within the convert all pages method, I read the Word document using the file stream instance. Next, I create a new instance for the Word document class and initialize it with the file stream object. Then I initialize the DocIO renderer instance for converting the Word document to an image. The Word document class has a method called renderAsImages, which converts Word documents to images. Each page in the Word document will be converted to a separate image. This method will return an array of streams, where each stream refers to an image. Here, using that method, I convert the whole document into images. Next, I am going to convert each stream to an image. There may be more than one image stream, so I am going to create a zip file and add the image files inside it. First, I include the system compression namespace to use zip archive class. I create a memory stream instance. Then, I initialize a zip archive class on the created memory stream with the zip archive mode as create mode. Following that, I iterate through the converted image streams. Before processing the stream, I initialize the stream position to 0. Next, I create an empty zip archive entry with the name of the image to be saved. Then, I open the zip archive entry, which returns the stream that represents the contents of the entry. And now I copy the bytes of the image stream to the entry stream. I increment this local variable to change the image name dynamically. And finally, I return the zip file from the memory stream with the specified content type and name. Now, let me save and run the application. I click this button to convert the Word document to an image. I open the downloaded zip file. You can see four images, as there were four pages in the document. Next, I will show you how to convert a range of pages into images. In the range of pages method, I am reusing the code from the previous conversion example. But, for converting a specific range of pages, I am making a renderAsImages method call with an overload that accepts two integer parameters. The first parameter is the start page index, and the second parameter is the number of pages. The pages that fall in this range will be converted into images. I want to convert only the second and third pages of the document into images. So I have set the start index to 1 and the number of pages to 2. See, here only the second and third pages are converted to images. And finally, I will show you how to convert the first page of a Word document into an image and use it for a thumbnail. Here again, I copy the code from the previous example and reuse it here. I remove the code used for the zip file, since I am exporting only one page. I call the renderAsImages method with an overload to specify the page index and the image format type. I specified the page index as 0 and image format as JPEG. I use the image stream to create an image file and return it. Let me show you the output of this code. See, the downloaded image is the first page of the Word document. In this video, I showed you how to add Syncfusion Word Library in aspdotnetcore web application. Then I showed you how to convert a Word document into images, including the first page and specific range of pages. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a community license to use our document processing libraries for free. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.